Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال أيضا يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا وقال يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما وبعد Indeed, all praise and glory is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek His aid and His forgiveness. We believe in Him and rely upon Him. We seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection and refuge against the evil of our own souls and against the evil of our impious deeds. Whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, none can misguide. And whomsoever is misguided, none can guide him except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we testify and we bear witness to the fact that there's no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is alone without any partner. And we also testify and bear witness to the fact that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's last messenger and his perfect worshipper. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I want to talk about a very important topic today, which is the mercy of the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because there are people that are trying to vilify Muslims and say that Muslims cannot function in a pluralistic society. That Muslims and non-Muslims, they can't coexist. And they try to talk about negatively about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And unfortunately, many times we as Muslims, we don't know how to respond to these claims. So in today's khutbah, inshallah, I'm going to talk about two aspects. One is the aspect of mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in general. And the second aspect is the mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam specifically to non-Muslims. Because if you look at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He praised the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ, that O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you are of the most exalted and upright character and conduct. In another verse, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ, that indeed in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you have the best example for you. In another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we have sent you as a mercy to the world. So we need to see, what does this mean? How was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam merciful? One of the examples that we find in the Sunnah and the Seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there were times when he was hurt sallallahu alaihi wasallam because of what people did and what people said. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam never allowed those incidents to cloud his vision of seeing the potential good in people. There are people trying to divide communities, nations, based on many different things. But we need to see, how would the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam respond to these things? In a hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, Aisha radiallahu anha, she narrates that I went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam one time and I asked, have you encountered a day which is harder and more difficult than the day of the Battle of Uhud? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said yes. And then he talked about the incident in which he sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to Taif and presented Islam to the people of Taif. And he said that they had troubled me a lot, and so I departed and they did not respond to my demand. So I departed overwhelmed with excessive sorrow. He was hurt sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was trying to call them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with Zayd ibn Haritha, and they not only were disrespectful to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they also had their children trying to throw things at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So there's something which was difficult. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I was overcome with sorrow and I found myself that I was not able to relax until I found myself at a place called Al-Qarna Tha'lam, where I lifted my head towards the sky to see a cloud shading me unexpectedly. I looked up and I saw Jibreel alayhi salam. He called me saying, Allah has heard what your people said to you and what they have replied to you with. Allah has sent the angel of the mountains to you so that you may order him to do whatever you wish to these people. The angel of mountains called and said salam to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, order what you wish. If you like, I will put al-akhshabain, the two mountains. I will make these two mountains fall on them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, no. But I hope that Allah will let them have children who will worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and will worship none besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in spite of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam being hurt, going through difficulty, it was the mercy of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam that he allowed these people to live so that perhaps they could worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And many of those people and their successive generations ended up accepting Islam. And this is the mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Another incident happened with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he used to have a Jewish boy that used to serve the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And one day, he became sick. Right? If even people close to us, right? Sometimes even our own relatives, right? If they become sick, many of us, we fail to visit them. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, out of his mercy, he went and he visited the person. In that society, this was also unheard of. That who visits their servants? But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went and he visited him, even though he was not Muslim. He went, and Anas radiallahu anhu narrates A young Jewish boy who used to serve the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he became sick. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to visit him. He sat near his head and asked him to embrace Islam. The boy looked at his father, who was sitting there. The father looked at his son and told him, "Obey Abu Qasim. Listen to what he's saying and accept Islam." So the boy accepted Islam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Alhamdulillah, praise be to Allah who saved the boy from the fire of hell." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has his mercy for that child, even though he's not Muslim, that caused him to go there, to visit him, to sit with him, and to invite him to Islam. Another incident that happened is that the mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not something which was just to the Muslims or non-Muslims, but it was to all of creation. There was an incident where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this is a miracle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's an authentic hadith. Abdullah ibn Ja'far radiallahu anhu said, "The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam sat behind me on his ride one day and told me secretly a thing and asked me not to tell it to anyone. The place for easing, the place where they were going, right, they were going to a place. And at that place, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he saw a camel. And the camel was crying. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to the camel. He wiped the camel's forelock in the front. And he said, 'Whose camel is this?' A young man from the Ansar came and said, 'This is mine, O Messenger of Allah.' The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam then said, 'Don't you fear Allah about this beast which Allah has given you in your possession? It has complained to me that you kept it hungry and you loaded heavily, which fatigues it.'" And he complained to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the person, he understood that he was treating the camel unfairly and unjustly. So the mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if we follow the prophetic method, we need to have mercy. We need to have mercy with our children. We need to have mercy with our spouses. We need to have mercy with Muslims, non-Muslims, with creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even with trees, everything needs to be shown mercy. And this is the mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, sometimes, because of certain circumstances and situations, our human aspects come out. And even in the companions, this happened. There's an incident where Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrates that people came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam one time, and they asked him, "O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, invoke curse, send la'na on the mushrikeen." Send la'na on the mushrikeen. They didn't specify who, but any person that commits shirk, "O Messenger of Allah, curse them, send la'na upon them." So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how did he reply? He said, "I have not been sent as an invoker of curse, but I have been sent as a mercy." And this is the prophetic method, right? There are people that today, they may hate Islam, they may hate Muslims, they may work at dividing communities, societies, but it's very easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide them. And they can become assets. And this is what the prophetic method teaches us. Always see the potential good in people. Have faith and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had faith and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The last hadith I'll mention, the first part of the khutbah, is the hadith of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu mentioned an incident which is worthy of reflection. And this hadith is recorded in Sahih Muslim. He said, "I invited my mother, who was a mushrika, who was someone who was committing shirk, to Islam. I invited her one day, and she said to me something about Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which I hated. I came to Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam weeping and said, 'Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I invited my mother to Islam, but she did not accept my invitation. I invited her today, but she said to me something which I did not like.'" Right? And not only directly to him, she was insulting the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Kindly make dua to Allah that he may set the mother of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu right, meaning guide her to Islam. Thereupon, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he do? If somebody told us that someone, my mother has insulted you, make dua for her. We would be like, why would we make dua for her? She's cursing us. She's insulting us. But the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he made dua for the mother of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. He said, oh Allah, set the mother of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu on the right path. I came out quite pleased with the supplication of Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Think about this. He came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a state which he was weeping. And then when he left that meeting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was in a state of happiness because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua for his mother. So he said, I went on the. I came out quite pleased with the supplication of Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When I came near the door to my house, it was closed from within. My mother heard the noise of my footsteps, and she said, O Abu Huraira, just wait. And I heard the noise of falling water. She took a bath and put on the shirt and quickly covered her hair with the headdress and opened the door and then said, Abu Huraira, I bear witness to the fact that there's no one worthy of worship except for Allah. And I also testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger. And then I went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this time I was shedding the tears of joy. I said, Allah's messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, be happy, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has responded to your dua, and he has set on the right path the mother of Abu Huraira. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praised Allah and extolled him and uttered good words. I said, Allah's messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, make dua to Allah so that he may instill love of mine and that of my mother too in the believing servants, and let our hearts be filled with their love. Whereupon Allah's messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made a dua. O Allah, let there be love of these servants of yours, meaning Abu Huraira and his mother, in the hearts of the believing servants, and let their hearts be filled with the love of the believing servants. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu later said, this prayer was so well granted and accepted by Allah. Then he said, by Allah, that no believer was ever born who heard of me and who saw me but did not love me. This is the mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That there would be people that would insult him, curse him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the good in people, to guide people. And not only that, had he made dua for Allah to guide her, that would be sufficient. But after she accepted Islam, then a request was made that instill, put love for her in the hearts of the believers. That's why after companions and the students of the companions, the tabi'een, they make a specific dua for Abu Huraira and his mother because of this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the mercy of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to bring people together, not to push them further away. Pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he grants us all the ability to be merciful to each other, to be merciful to others, to be merciful to his creation. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in all aspects of our lives. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَكُلِّ ذَنْبٍ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله على فضله وإحسانه وأشكره على توفيقه وامتنانه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبعد, one of the most neglected aspects of being merciful is within our own houses. When we have authority, it's easy for us to forget the concept of mercy, right? Because we're saying that sometimes when we're outside, we don't have any power. This is called ajz, right? We don't have the ability to be merciful, so we say we're merciful. No. But within our houses, it's extremely important that we show love, kindness, tenderness, and mercy. Because this is what relationships are based on. Right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the marital relationship, he said it's based on love and mercy. An incident happened during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was with children and he kissed his grandchildren. And one of the Bedouins said that I have 10 children and I've never kissed any one of them. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, how can it be if Allah has removed mercy from someone's heart? In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man la yarham la yurham." That whoever is not merciful will not be shown mercy. I know sometimes culturally we may say, no, the people of our men, we don't show affection. The people of our culture, the men of our culture, we don't show affection in this way. But if the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed affection in this way, then this is the method and role model that we follow. Sometimes the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed affection by helping around the house, by spending time with the children, by not becoming angry. There was a time where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had a child, right, holding a child, and the child urinated on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't get angry, didn't get upset. He said, just bring some water. That's it. And this is the mercy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, unfortunately, and this is something that I'm hesitant to share, but people have made certain aspects of Islam so rigid that the younger generation, they're scared. They're scared about learning about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam because anything that they've learned has been devoid of mercy. We need to teach our children about the loving, kind, compassionate nature of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That anything that he said, anything that he did, was because he wanted goodness for people. And he wanted people to be successful in this dunya and the akhirah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, he told the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّ مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, if you were rough, if you were coarse, if you were hard-hearted, the people would run away from you. Even though the message is the same, even if the message is the same. So similarly, yes, we want ourselves, our families, the people around us to learn about Islam, to learn about the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, but we need to present it also in the method of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One of the most difficult things for people to understand is when there's a contradiction between our words and our actions, especially younger children. So we need to learn that we need to implement the teachings of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As we emphasize our prayers, as we emphasize our ibadat, even in our akhlaq, our mu'amalat, the way that we treat each other, we need to look at the method and the guidance of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and take him as a role model in every aspect of our lives. If we do, then we will have success in this dunya and the akhirah. Respect, dignity, all of that is in the possession of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gives us the ability to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he softens our hearts. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he increases us all in love, mercy, compassion towards each other, and he guides all of our affairs. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم فاذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون أقيموا الصلاة. This film, the front